Hi guys, I'm Shyam from websitelearners.com. Today I'm going to show you how you can add new users to your WordPress site. So let's say you have a website and you're the only person working on your site. Now if you want to let another person contribute to your site, you can do it by adding a new user in WordPress. Now when you add a new user, you can give that user access to specific parts of your site. So for example, if you want this person to write blog posts for you, you can give them access to just blog posts on your site. And they won't be able to make any other changes. Now, if you want to give this user full access, you can choose their access so that they can control the entire site. So let's get started. First, we are going to see how to add a new user in WordPress. To add a new user, let's go to our WordPress dashboard and then go to users and click add new. Now here, we have to enter the details of the new user. So first, let's enter a username for this user and then enter their email and their name. So once you have entered these details, just click show password to get the password for this user. And WordPress will give you a default password for this user. Now if you want to change this password, just delete this and then enter your own password. Once you have entered all the details, you need to select the role of this user. So let's click here. And you can see that WordPress has different roles you can keep for the new user. First, let's look at the administrator role. So we'll select that. And after you have selected the role, just copy this username and password into a notepad. We are going to use these details in the next step. So let's open Notepad and then copy this username and then the password. So once you have copied it, just click Add User. And you can see that we have successfully added the new user. And it appears on our users list. Now how will this user access our website? Now let's open Notepad. Now, in order to let this user access our WordPress site, you need to share this username and password with that user. So once you have shared these details, the user will be able to log into your site. So next, let's see how the user can log into our site. So let's open a new tab, and let's say this is the user's browser window. First, they need to enter your site's address and then type /login. So my site is quicktechie.com. So I'm going to enter that. And then I'm going to add /login. Now when they press enter, it'll take them to the login page of your website. So now the user has to enter their username and password which you have shared with them. So let's open Notepad and then copy the username and password into the login page. Now if we click login, you can see that we have logged in as a new user. So this is how a new user can log into your website. So after logging in, the user is able to access all the options from the WordPress dashboard. Now since we selected this user's role as administrator, they will be able to control everything on this site. For example, from this account, we can change the theme or install a new plugin or even add new users to the site. Now, if you don't want to give access to all of these settings of your site, you can restrict their access by changing their role in WordPress. So next, let's see how we can change the role of a user. So to change the role, let's go back to our main WordPress account, which is here, and here you can see the user which we added before. Now let's click edit, and if you scroll down, you can see the role which we selected before, which is administrator. Now let's change this role by clicking here, and you'll see different roles available for the user. Now let's look at the most important roles which you can set for your users. The first role is the administrator role, which gives the full access of your site to the user.
If you want someone to build your site or fix an issue with your site, you can give them the administrator role. So after the administrator role, there are three useful roles which you can keep for your users: the editor, author, and contributor. So first, let's look at the editor role. Now, when you select the user's role as editor, the user will be able to edit all of your posts and pages. But they won't have access to any other setting, such as your themes and plugins. So let's try it out. We'll select editor. And then scroll down and click update. Now let's go back to our user's account. And now we have selected our user's role as editor. So if we click refresh, you can see that most of the settings are hidden now, and the user can only access your posts and pages. Now if we go inside pages, you can see that we are able to edit or delete any of these pages. So this is what the editor role does. Now let's go back to the dashboard again. And let's try the next role. So let's click here. And let's look at the author role. Now in WordPress, whenever you publish a post, it'll be linked to the user who published it. So each post in WordPress will have a user linked to it. Now the author role will allow the user to create their own posts and then edit those posts. But they won't be able to edit any posts which are created by other users. So let's try out the author role. We'll select it. And then scroll down and click update user. And now we have selected the author role. So let's refresh our user's dashboard. And you can see that the pages access has been removed for this role. Now if we go to posts, you can see that as these posts were created by a different user, we can only view these posts and we cannot edit them. But as an author, we can click add new and we can write and publish our own posts. Now if I click publish, this post will be live on our site. So this is what the author role does. So next, let's see the contributor role. We'll go back to our users page and let's select the role as contributor. Now when you select contributor, the user can write new posts, but it has to be approved by you before it can be published. So let's try it out. Let's select contributor. And then scroll down and click update user. Okay, so now we have selected the role as contributor. So let's click refresh. Now if we go to posts, you can see that we cannot edit any posts. And if we click add new, you can see that instead of the publish button, we have submit for review. So as you can see, the contributor does not have access to publishing anything. But he can write his own post and then submit for review. So next, let's try submitting a post for review. We'll write a new post and then click submit for review. Now if we go to our main account and click posts, you can see that we have got the contributor's post, which is marked as pending. Now to publish this post, all you have to do is go to edit and then click publish. And as soon as you click publish, this post will appear on your site. So this is how the contributor role works. The contributor can write new posts, but it won't be published unless it's approved by an editor or an admin. So these are the four main roles you can set for the user. First is admin, then we have editor, author, and contributor.
So that's it guys, this is how you can add new users to your WordPress site and choose what they can access. Next, if you want to create a business email for your website, you can watch this video. It shows you how you can create a business email for free. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.